Ryan, tell us about This Saves Lives and your journey to getting here.
Well, This Saves Lives is a social impact company, but I like to say that we're actually a mission with a company, not a company with a mission. And that means everything that we do at This Saves Lives is driven to end child malnutrition around the world. Now, it started when myself and one of our co-founders, Todd Grinnell, traveled to Liberia, and we saw these babies and these kids who were suffering from malnutrition. We decided that we needed to do something about it. We're actors. We came back. We teamed up with a couple other actor friends of ours, Kristen Bell and Ravi Patel. And we knew that there was a business solution to ending the malnutrition crisis. We didn't exactly know what it was at first, but what we landed on was a direct give back company. So at This Saves Lives, for every product we sell, you send life-saving food to a child in need around the world. We started with kind of our classic line of snack bars, like fruit and nut bars, really delicious gourmet. And those are our kind of our classic line of bars. Then we spread out and just recently launched two new lines. One is our kids line of bars, and they're absolutely delicious. I've got a four-year-old. He's a tough critic, and he loves them. They're school safe, so they're free of the top 8 allergens. They're low sugar. They're really delicious. And then we also have a line of collagen bites, which gets us into kind of ingestible beauty. It's functional. It's a functional ingredient. It's collagen, but there's also superfoods, really gourmet ingredients, really helping you to feel beautiful inside and out. For everyone sold, you know, we donate this life-saving food to a child in need around the world. We're in 9 countries, and we've donated more than 11 million packets of food aid around the world, which is enough to help save more than 70,000 children's lives and growing.
And as an entrepreneur and as a parent, we are faced with many choices. So what are the driving factors behind how you make decisions?
Look, everything that we kind of drive from at This Saves Lives, but also as me as a parent, really comes from this kind of need to make an impact, a positive impact, you know, on the world, whether it's how I parent my son and here at the company as well. It's, you know, how can we drive a positive impact knowing that that's really rooted in happiness? There's kind of these 3 levels of happiness that scientists talk about, right? The lowest level of happiness is like that hit that you get when you buy something, really short-lived. The middle level is like when you're immersed in something you love to do, like flow. It's like when you're playing a sport or playing an instrument where you kind of lose that time. It's that flow happiness. It's like kind of like, it's pretty good, but it's over when the activity's over. The deepest, richest level of happiness is that of being a part of something that's bigger than yourself. You find the thing that you're passionate about, that thing that is bigger than you, and you go at that like it's your North Star. It feels good to do good, and doing good is good for business. That doesn't have to mean that you have a strong social impact mission. I hope you do, because it's really good. But even if you're just like grinding away, but you know that, hey, if I do, you know, a great job with my team, if I can drive them from a point of view that I know they're going to find some fulfillment in the work that they're doing, they're going to work harder, they're going to be happier, and that's going to make you happier as a leader. It's really identifying that thing that's going to make people feel like they're a part of something that's bigger than themselves.
How have you found that being a parent has influenced the way you run your company?
Being a parent made me want to drive towards the mission even that much harder. I think at the same time, it required me to focus. When you've got no kids, you can just work all the time. I would just work till midnight and wake up at 5 and keep working, and I work through meals and all that. And now I never miss a bath time. Like, bath is the best. And so it's forced me to focus more, and I think focus more on how I can be the most efficient and the most impactful with my time while I'm at work, and be the most present and the most loving with my family when I'm not at work.
Do you have any dad life hacks in there?
Oh, I've got so many dad life hacks, but they work for me. I don't know if they work for everybody.
Okay, go for it.
I would say the 2 things that really changed me and made me a better father, my wife would attest to this, were a regular practice of mindfulness meditation. I would recommend for anybody, there's a million apps out there. There's the Calm app and the Headspace app and all that. They're really wonderful. They're super cheap. And I've found it really changed me as a leader at the company and as a father. And for me, rock climbing is a really big thing for me. I think exercise in general is incredibly important. I was going to the gym a lot, and I was on the treadmill or something like that, and I was just constantly thinking about work or home. And so I was exercising, but I wasn't releasing the tension from my brain. It was just coming out of my body. And so when I'm rock climbing, I'm not thinking about our spreadsheets or our performance or the meeting that I have, or even, you know, like my son's schedule for the next day. I'm just thinking about that moment. And so even in that sense, it's meditative. find the thing that can help you unplug for a second. What we get back is far more focus and far more drive. And I think that's important for everybody to do.
Ryan, thank you so much.